Hi, welcome back to Who May Be a Leader. And as we continue biblical counseling framework for life, we're in Ephesians chapter 5, starting in verse 7, I think we stopped at last time. And I want to continue because we're talking about being an imitator of God. And he's talking about some things that we are not to partake in, darkness, because the contrast between darkness, and he talks about how to know we're in darkness based on Galatians chapter 5. Not only that, he talks about walking in the light. So he talked about that contrast of knowing when we're in the light. And that's what we need to be trying to understand, how to know when you're in the light, how to know when you're walking in the darkness. And that's the thing about it. Verse 7 says, therefore, do not be a partaker. Partaker of what? Immorality and impurity. Not only that, because he say the wrath of God come down on the sons of disobedience. What we talked about last time is nobody is getting away with anything. So don't waste your time sitting around thinking that a person is getting away with something, even if they mistreating you unjustly, because God say we find favor with him based on 1 Peter when we get treated under. He say, so don't be a protector. He say, for you was formerly in the darkness, now you're in the light. And he talk about what the fruit of the light is. He say, learn what pleases the Lord and just do it. Do not be a partaker of unfruitful deed of darkness, but instead expose them. Now, that's one of the hardest things for us to do. We expose them with rudeness, but we don't know how to expose them and encourage them and nurture them and really walk with them. Because when we, a lot of times, we think we got to get angry and get all riled up to expose somebody. You have to be careful, because the same way in which you expose somebody, somebody may expose you in the same way. So what I'm saying, he say expose them with a gentleness, lest you look at you, because you may get caught up in that. So remember, he called, he said, don't walk in darkness and walk in the fruit of the light, which is good, righteousness, and truth. Try to learn. He said, do not participate in unfruitful, for if it is disgraceful even to speak of these things which are done by them in secret, but all things become visible when they are exposed by the light, meaning the light of the word, it becomes visible. For everything that becomes visible is the light. For this reason, it said, awaken, you sleeper, arise from the dead, and Christ will shine on you. Therefore, be careful. Now, this is one of my favorite scriptures. He said, be careful how you walk, not as unwise men, but as wise men, making the most of your time, for the days are evil. Now, we can see some evil days, and we still walking as unwise men. We still walking with our eyes closed. One of the reasons why I chose 1 Corinthians 16:13, when it talks about be on alert, stand firm in your faith, act like men, because I think that is the basic criteria for a man to be looking to do, is to be on alert. Now, what alerts you? The Word of God alerts you. If you are a professing Christian and not reading the Word of God, not getting into the Word of God, then you're not going to be able to be alert. You're going to miss a lot of things. First and foremost, you're going to miss things in your own life. Then you're going to start missing things in your family life, because you're going to let stuff slide. Because one of the things that we have the ability to do is when we're not walking in a way that we should, we feel guilty when we try to discipline somebody else when they're not walking right. Say, for instance, you got a child that's not walking right, and the fact is, you know, you haven't been walking right. You find it hard to do that, to really come down on that kid the way you know you should, because you feel like you don't have the right to, because you're not, you let a lot of things slide. And God is saying that we need to be careful how we walk. We need to be, walk as wise men. And not only that, you need to have some accountability, somebody to hold you. And you want to get with somebody that's wise. You don't want to get with just on anybody. Matter of fact, he said, we're not to sit in the counsel of the ungodly. Too many of us are getting advice from those who are not in the Word. They might be saved, but they're not in the Word. From people that's even not saved, sometimes we're getting advice from them, and God is saying we're not to sit in the counsel of the ungodly, and we need to be careful of that. So he said, be careful how you walk, not as unwise men, but as wise men, making the most of your time. I remember when I took a time management class, and he talked about making the most of your time. How do you do that? Well, one of the advice that he gave me, he said, each day you should get up with a plan. And you should work that plan. And if something come along to disrupt that plan, if you can get off of your plan that you have, go do what needs to be done and maybe help somebody and get back on your plan to be able to finish it for that day, then that's okay. But if you can't, it's okay that you tell people that you can't help them. Because we think a lot of the time, because we're Christian, that every time somebody asks you for help, that you got to inconvenience yourself and go help them. I'm not saying that's what you shouldn't help them, but I'm saying if it's going to inconvenience you, then it just because it's going to make you look like that you're a good person because you went to help them, it's going to inconvenience you. And then next thing you know, you are all out of your element of trying to do something that another person have asked you to do. He said, make the most of your time, for the days are evil. These are evil days. All you have to do is look at the TV. I mean, people are getting away with all kind of stuff. And it's going to get worse because we're on a crunch. And then a lot of us who are professing Christians have bought into this world system. And God is saying that, hey, you need to keep your eyes fixed on me, because I'm the author and the finisher of my faith. I remember speaking to a group of deacons, and we was talking about prosperity and how we prosper and stuff like that. And at that time they was talking about material things as far as their jobs and money and stuff like that. And a lot of them say they prosper when they was under the Clinton administration. And I'm saying I prosper all alone, because the fact is that it is God who give it and it is God who take it. It is God that uses presidents, he uses leaders, he used whatever means possible, but God has blessed me all that I can remember as I serve him. He has blessed me. I can tell you story after story how God has provided for me, not just necessarily monetary thing, how he have saved me when I didn't even know he was paying attention, how God has moved things out of my way when I had a plan to go do disruptive thing. God has done that for me, because that's what he would do when you're a child of his and he know that you have a heart after him. That's why it made David so special. It wasn't because David was perfect in everything. David did some treacherous things. The whole thing with Bathsheba, killing her husband. David did some new things. But David had a heart for God, because he knew that God was the only one that can save him from whatever it is that he was caught up in. And that's what we need to get. We need to know that we have a God that can do anything. I don't care what it is. God can do it. But now, don't misunderstand God with some genie now, because that's not the way it works. That's why I say we need to understand how it is that God operates and what he's calling us to do as his people, because there ought to be benefits to serving God. It ought to not look the same as the world. There ought to be benefits to where God can shine through you, to where people who are not saved can look, because you are standing firm in your faith and they see this, and guess what? It glorifies your Father in heaven. And so he said that understand what the will of God is for that, and just do it. Verse 19, speaking to one another in psalms and hymns, spiritual songs, singing and making melody with your heart to the Lord. Always give thanks. Always give thanks. Always give thanks. That's a difficult thing to do. It's difficult for me, because a lot of time when you're going down, man, you don't feel like giving thanks, but you got to know who God is in order to be able to give him thanks through your trials and tribulation. So he said, always give thanks for the things in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to God, even the Father, and be subject to one another in the fear of Christ. Be subject to one another in the fear of Christ. And there you have it. That's what you call being an imitator of God. And that's what God has called us to do. Hey, until we see you next time, I'm so excited to be back with you. God has truly blessed us over here. And he's just continuing to move us forward. I'm excited about what's on the horizon. I know some things have been moving kind of slow. But you got to understand that we don't have a full staff. A lot of this stuff we doing ourselves. And we just hoping that God would bless it as we continue to do it in his name. Hey, until I see you next time, may God bless you and keep you as our prayer. And remember, examine your life so you can balance your life. God bless you.